In this video, we will modify our workspace so that it allows for self-serve data access. We will perform the following: create published parameters in FME Workbench, publish the workspace to FME Server, and run the workspace from the web user interface. The workspace we have is pretty straightforward, taking data from a file geodatabase and writing it to the generic format. Parameters in FME control how FME operates. They exist in many places, such as readers, writers, and transformers. Take a closer look at one of the parameters for the generic writer, output format. Double-clicking on this parameter shows that it's been set up so the user can select from any format in the formats gallery. But that's not what we want. The goal here is to present the user with a list of four common formats. We will need to create a new user parameter and define it accordingly. Right-click on the Published Parameters node and select Add Parameter. For type, select Choice with Alias. For name, enter Output Format. For prompt, enter Output Format. Click the button next to Configuration. We are going to import the formats we want, so click on Import, then Writer Formats. Search for and select Esri Shapefile, Map Info Tab, GML, MicroStation Design V8, and click OK, and OK again. Select Esri Shapefile for the default value. Notice that, by default, Published is checked off. When a user parameter is published, a user is prompted for a value when the workspace runs. Click OK. All published parameters have a purple cogwheel. Our new output format parameter appears under Published Parameters, but we still have to link it to the generic writer's output format parameter. Locate the output format parameter of the generic writer. Right-click on Output Format, select Link to User Parameter, then select the new output format parameter we just created. Notice how the cogwheel icon has turned purple. One more thing. We will set up the workspace so the user gets to choose which layers they want to request. It's actually quite simple. Expand the reader, parameters, features to read. This parameter lets the user decide which feature types to process when the workspace is run. Right-click on Feature Types to Read and select Create User Parameter. We will go with the defaults for the definition, so click OK. Confirm the new parameter appears under Published Parameters. Go ahead and run the workspace, but first, make sure that the Run with Prompt is checked. Otherwise, this workspace will run with default values. Notice there are two parameters to set. Okay, let's cancel this and get the workspace up on FME Server. Go to File, Publish to FME Server, connect to your FME Server. In the next dialog, select the Server Tutorial Repository. Call the workspace communitymapping.fmw. The existing one will be overwritten. Register the workspace with the data download service. You can leave the job submitter checked. Click Publish and confirm in the log that the workspace was published successfully. Now open the FME Server web user interface. Click Run Workspace. On the Run Workspace page, select Server Tutorial, the Community Mapping Workspace, and Data Download. Now check out the published parameters. You will see the two that we set up and tested in Workbench. Just as before, select an output format, select one or more layers, then click Run Workspace. The data download service presents a URL link to the translation results in a zip file. A quick inspection of the contents of the zip file confirms that the results are what we expected.